So good morning friends. So today we are going to discuss on a topic called prefixes and suffixes to form derivatives. So firstly, before knowing about prefixes and suffixes, let us see what is meant by a word called derivative. See, derivatives are like the most powerful tools which will help you to build vocabulary like very easily and quickly. And so these derivatives are like, see, for example, we'll see the examples. The word derivative has come from the verb derive, which means the action of having or taking something from an underlying source. So it means having some root word somewhere and taking a part out of the root word. So taking something out of the root word or a base word, that's called a derivative here. So again, I'll read. So the word derivative has come from the verb derive, which means the action of having or taking something from an underlying source. So before knowing about prefixes and suffixes, so derivative example, I'll just show you. Yeah, so here are the few examples of derivatives. So first example, let me tell you that orange juice is the derivative of oranges. So what is the underlying source here? Orange is an underlying source, and out of an orange, so orange juice has been taken out. So is that clear that? So let me repeat it again. So here the example of the word derivative is that it means the action of having or taking something from an underlying source. So here underlying source or a base word or a root word, so out of it a word will be formed. So we'll see here orange juice is a derivative of oranges. So here orange, so out of orange juice is an underlying source here. It means oranges is an underlying source, and oranges is a derivative word, and here orange juice is taken out from oranges. So we'll see the next example, that wood is a derivative of a tree. So here, so out of an underlying source or out of something, there'll be a something taken out again. So it means here the underlying source is tree in the second example here, and out of tree wood has been taken out. So wood is a derivative because it has been taken out from other source, and that source is tree. And next, the word, we'll see the other example. The word herb is a derivative of the Latin word herba, means grass. So here, the main point out of all this is that, so let me repeat about this derivative again. See, in any languages, like derivatives are formed from the base words. So there'll be a base word, and out of that base word, we are going to form another word. That's called the derivative. And of course, they're often used to transfer the root word into a grammatical category even. So that can be chosen, that can be selected even for a grammatical category. So for example, like making a verb into a noun. So that's called a derivation in a sentence. So we're changing the sentence, the word, taking the word verb into a noun, or as an adjective into an adverb. So here there are many more things derivatives can do too, and so hope it is clear about the derivatives. Let me tell you again. So it means the action of taking something from an underlying source. So this example is the best example here. Orange juice is a derivative of oranges. This is the main source. Oranges is the main source, and orange juice has been taken out from the oranges, and that's called a derivative. Because orange juice has come from another source. It has been taken out from another source. Alright. And yeah. So it's called a derivative. And what are these prefixes and affixes? We'll see here. Suffixes. So what is an affix? So affixes are the group of letters like which stuck to a word which changes its meaning. And so I hope you all know what is meant by a prefix and a suffix. So before talking about an affix, let me tell you what is meant by a prefix or an affix.
The prefix, the word itself is very easy to understand that something which is fixed at the beginning of a word, prefix, isn't it? And which where the word has been adding at the end of a word, that suffix. Adding at the end of a word, pre, it is beginning, and suffix, it is at the end. And these two together called as an affix. Alright, so there will be a root word. For example, I'll tell you.
So let us take a word called happy. And the word happy is the root or the base word. And adding a prefix to the word happy is that unhappy. We have added a prefix over there. Because prefixing is something to be fixed at the beginning of a word. And happiness.
So if I say happiness, so ness has been added to the end of a word called happy.
So these both the pre and ness together called as an affixes. Prefix and suffix together called as an affix. Alright.
So we'll see a few examples here. Honest, a root word meaning to speak the truth. So this is the root word. That's the root word or the base word we call. See, how can we identify the root word or a base word is that we couldn't divide the word into parts. Alright, so no phrases, nothing. We couldn't divide the word into parts. That's called a root word or a base word. For example, honest. Can we divide it like horne and est? No, it's not possible. So adding this horne, so this can be divided into this honest. So we have added a prefix called dis at the beginning of a word to honest because honest is a root word or a base word. And one more point is that adding a prefix or a suffix to the word, it changes the complete meaning of a sentence or changes the meaning of a word completely. Because here itself we can see that honest is being a very like speaking the truth, isn't it? But adding a prefix called dis at the beginning of a word changes the meaning of completely the meaning of a word. So it's the opposite of honest, it's dishonest. And honesty we say. So for example, if there is a word called honesty, so this can be divided like honest and why can be separated even though, see you can identify like though you separate a letter or words or letters from the root word, still, if the meaning survives, still the meaning exists, then it's called a base word or a root word. So we'll delete why, still honest, there's a meaning. But adding why also honesty, so there's a meaning. Of course, it has been taken like an adjective, you know. Grammatical part, keep it aside. Okay. And next. So here, how can we connect this prefix or suffix to a derivative? I'll tell you. So this is a prefix being added to the word honest, to the root word. This plus honest is equal to dishonest, a derivative of honest. So dishonest is a prefix. I'll tell you clearly. So this is prefix being added to the root word honest. But here, the whole word which has been added a prefix or suffix, this is called as a derivative. Alright. And yeah, so let me write the word called happy. Okay, so this is the root word and I am adding un to it. Now from unhappy, this whole word will be called as a derivative because unhappy has been taken out from the base word happy. Understand? Yeah, so that's called the root word and to form derivatives. So honorable. Honor is like giving a high respect to a person, to anyone. And honorable. So we have added a suffix to the word, root word honor. So though we delete able, there is a meaning still exists to the word honor. It means that's the root or a base word. And now, able is a suffix that has been added. And it says that, yeah, that's possible. Which is possible, we say able. So together, see, this one separately, if we take the these letters like A, B, L, E, these letters individually, like this word, it's called able. The particular word is called as a suffix. Okay. But together from honorable, the complete word is called as a derivative. So these are the suffixes or prefixes, and hope it's clear. So thank you.